You're watching the What's New with Motionworks IEC 3 video series. In this video, I'll demonstrate and explain some improved functionality that exists as a result of function block updates. Hi, I'm Matt Pelletier. Here's a quick preview. In Motionworks IEC version 3, we have improved a number of function blocks and added new ones. You can send text to the web UI, release servo motor holding brakes without the servo on. Y direct control now supports torque feed forward. Electronic cam can be engaged at an absolute master position. We also introduce a set of function blocks to support PLCopen part 4 for coordinated motion of multi-axis mechanisms. Now let's look at each of these in more detail. The programmer can send any text string to the controller's web UI debugging output using ydebug print. In the web UI, under status, you have debugging output. Now I'll execute ydebug print and refresh, and the message was sent to this debugging output. You can even save the file if you like. The idea is that important conditions can be detected in the code to execute the block. For example, if an e-stop is pressed, or there's low material, or you enter some sort of error state, a custom message can be sent to this debugging output. And the descriptive message would make it easier to troubleshoot using only the web browser. Ydebug print is part of the device.com firmware library and requires firmware 3.2 and higher. You can see I'm using firmware 3.3. Control of the holding brake is improved. The programmer can set conditions to release the built-in holding brake of a servo motor using the function block Y brake release. This way the axis can be moved externally with the servo off, for example during mechanical setup or calibration or troubleshooting. The servo motor brake is usually controlled by a relay that's driven by the servo pack brake output. Here I have an example demonstration of this. Right now the brake is engaged, so this brake output variable is true. Under normal operation, the brake output turns on and off as the servo turns on and off. Servo on, brake is off, or released, servo off, and the brake is engaged. Y brake release can also turn the brake output on and off. Each time it executes, that toggles the brake state. The brake is released, the servo is off, so right now it's possible to move the shaft of the servo motor by hand. And you execute the block again to return the brake output to the engaged state and resume control with servo on. Y brake release is part of the Y motion firmware library, and it requires firmware version 3.3 or higher. Application performance can be improved for winding applications by using Y direct control with torque feed forward control mode. In this type of application, servos drive the wind and unwind rolls. As the roll diameter changes, the torque requirements of the motor also change significantly, so the torque feed-forward amount can be calculated and gradually changed to predict the torque requirements as that roll diameter changes. This allows the speed loop to operate more effectively, minimizing the variation in tension and resulting in a high-quality product. Torque feed-forward with direct position control is helpful in positioning custom kinematic mechanisms. This allows the controller to command an estimated torque required for smooth motion of the mechanism, leaving the position and speed loops to react to any remaining error more efficiently. This type of advanced control is especially helpful for these nonlinear mechanisms. Engaging an electronic cam is simplified using the engage method called @absoluteposition. With this method, a future absolute position of the master is specified as the engage position instead of the master position within a cycle. For example, in a rotary knife application, the knife starts disengaged from the master. You write code to capture the master position of the first product, add an offset, and execute the YCAM in block. The cam automatically engages at the specified absolute position of the master. It is not necessary to write additional code to wait for a number of cam master cycles or to calculate an initial shift. Multi-axis coordinated motion is programmed using the PLCopen Part 4 standard. Basic support is provided in version 3.0 for linear, circular, and direct moves, along with basic group operations like enable, disable, stop, and reset. I'm using version 3.3. Beyond the standard blocks, we offer a set of Yaskawa-specific functionality, such as Y-group direct control for custom mechanisms, and Y-group power to turn on the servos for a group. We continue to develop this platform for multi-axis coordinated motion with blocks such as MC group read status and the group toolbox library with a variety of higher level function blocks. Thanks for watching this video, and go to yaskawa.com/IECSW to download the latest version of Motionworks IEC 3.